Keynote speech by Mr. Akom Teum Pithaya Phaisit, Minister of Finance.
Thank you very much, Kun Kita Sabawan, Resident Coordinator in Thailand, Governor of Bank of Thailand, Secretary General of Securities and Exchange Commission in Thailand, Kun Ruen Wadi, Dr. Pakorn, President of the Stock Exchange of Thailand, Kun Khatiya, Chief Executive Officer, Kasikorn Thai Bank, Dr. Si Kanya, Secretary General of the KPF, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great pleasure to be presiding over the opening of the signing ceremony on Sustainable Thailand. And I'm also really glad to see all of us joining us today from the key organization from public and private sector entities, both the commercial bank and state-owned banks, as well as the fund managers that have expressed their dedication and the intentions to help drive the country towards a sustainable Thailand. The topic today is very timely, particularly in time with the we are tackling the COVID-19, as well as we are talking about where we are going in the next few years for the post-COVID. The 13th National Economic and Social Development Plan will be also launched very soon. That will give the guideline for the country. For the Ministry of Finance, we have always been building a sustainable and resilient economy through various fiscal policies in short and long terms, including in time of economic turmoil hit by COVID-19 pandemic. As you are all aware, since last year, the Thai economy has severely been affected by a series of COVID-19 outbreaks. The government has taken quickly to contain the spread of the virus and to allocate all necessary fiscal and financial resources to assist the healthcare system and to relieve affected workers as well as businesses. Many government support programs, including co-payment and CHOP More, Get More, or co-payment, a particular co-payment 50-50, to name a few, have also conducted to sustain the level of domestic consumption. The supports will continue to the future growth prospect of Thai economy. As announced by the Ministry of Finance, we still believe that by 2021, our economic growth will be at the level of the 1.3%. This is quite optimistic in a way, as compared to the private sectors. But for next year, we will keep our momentum for the 4-5% economic growth for the next year. Distinguished guests, as we continue to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic to strive towards economic growth, the government has also put in place by laying foundation for Thailand's sustainable growth. Looking forward, the government will accelerate the effort and revitalize the Thai economy after the pandemic through three measures in the short term. First, providing full support to medical staff to combat COVID-19, both curation and vaccination. Second, income compensation for those who have been affected by COVID-19, both people and businesses. And third, revitalization of economic activities to secure a source of income and using more fiscal policy to issuing two emergency royal decrees on borrowing to finance the economic costs caused by the pandemic. Distinguished guests, for medium and to long-term recovery, the collaboration between the public and private sector is required, and there are six key aspects that I would like to touch upon. First, the promotion of biocircular green economy model, or BCG model, that we have been talking, some of the speaker has already mentioned. This economic model will focus on creating high value products from the biological resources, considering reusing various of materials as much as possible, and economic development that is environmentally friendly. The government has taken some measures such as the issuance of green, social and sustainability bond and the promotion of investment in electrical vehicles. In particular, the government has set up the National Committee on electric vehicles to save the energy and environment. The target is set for 2030 as well. Second, economic restructuring towards new industries. By accelerating investment in large-scale infrastructure projects, as well as focusing on the investment in 12 targeted industries or the new S-curve. The investment in Eastern Economic Corridor, or EEC, which will be the new engines of growth, will enhance Thailand's competitiveness and improve the productivity of the economy. Third, digital economy is another key to increasing Thailand's competitiveness. Both private and public sectors must focus on digital transformation. The government is facilitating the public by introducing e-tax filing, state-owned enterprise transaction in order to reduce costs associated with cash transaction. Fourth, creating a well-established social safety net. All citizens will be able to receive proper social protections from various schemes, such as Social Security Fund, Provident Fund, Government Pension Fund, and of course, National Saving Funds. For National Saving Funds, the Cabinet just approved the allocation for budget for the National Saving Funds just last week. Fifth, reducing poverty and inequality. By implementing an economic policy that improves the welfare system, quality of life of the people, and enhancing the development of agricultural and rural economy. Lastly, the role of financial and capital markets is important as the tools to divert our resources to what we would like to see, particularly green financing, in our shared vision of sustainable development. Distinguished guests, the Sustainable Thailand 2021 or 2022 project is a collaboration between government agencies, institutional investors and banks in an attempt to announce their intention to operate and achieve their businesses under the Sustainable Development Goals. The collaboration seeks to apply principles of responsible investment and principles of responsible banking for conducting business together. It helps drive sustainable business operation, as well as strengthen the role of Thai investment and banking institutions towards sustainability at the regional and global levels. Honorable guests, now, it's the time that I would like to thank the United Nations for organizing this forum, and of course, both public and private sector, especially our banks who are going to play an important role to finance and gearing the financial resources towards the more high technology and greener businesses to make our planet safe from climate effect. Lastly, let me congratulate to all stakeholders who are going to be part of the signing the commitment of the statement Sustainable Thailand. I hope that this venue will be a place where everyone can exchange and create constructive ideas to help Thailand economy grow in a sustainable way. By the way, not only the discussion today, but I hope that the more concrete action will be implemented by all stakeholders. And I hope that we shall meet every year to monitor what we are doing, what we have been doing, and what will be the lesson learned for the other agencies as well. Thank you very much.